December 2017, I set out on a journey to Sri Lanka. After one intense year of master's in social entrepreneurship, it was emotionally overwhelming for me to find my purpose. So, with a burning soul, I set out on this journey to find my place in the world, to see what my heart connects with, what is my way of giving back, the cause that I can take responsibility of and make the reason of my existence. UNDP and ISEC facilitated a volunteering program, a training and traveling program around Sri Lanka to schools, churches and village centers. I chose gender equality to teach the locals and create awareness about the gender bias related effects. If possible, convince them to break out of the social stigma they are told to live with. It's true that by giving back to the community, things begin to settle down for another start of what I call my independent introduction to social action. Meeting so many people who are unable to cross the stringent lines drawn by the community around them was not easy. If evolution is technology alone, then we are still very behind. My journey taught me that awareness of fundamental rights by every individual was the key to development of the world. If the bottom of the pyramid is unable to make use of what is approved to them, then how are we solving the problem? In fact, we are understanding the challenge differently from how it can be resolved. We saw that many listeners were uncomfortable hearing us speaking their rights to them. Very strange. Sri Lanka is a long story for a single shot. Hence, I break down my moments of impact and share about my uniquely special experience of a boy who wrote a letter to me after I gave the session on gender equality at a school. He writes, "If a girl is in trouble, and if I'm the only boy trying to help her, will everyone think in a different way and society make up stories? What do I have to do?" Let's look at the other side of the most common. The young boy took the initiative to write down his problems. He is scared of being supportive to his female friend. At such a young age, he is worried about society making up stories. Who is society? What are we ignoring while providing education? Peer pressure is unavoidable, but societal pressure for a kid? He's thinking about his friend's trouble, dealing with his reputation, confused about right and wrong, holding back to speak up because he knows he might be isolated further and still be able to balance himself. He did not stop helping his friend. He's persevering. He's ready to think about a sustainable solution. I answered him to do the right thing confidently and share with elders about the situation in detail without being scared, like how he came up to me. Society means nobody if we don't account ourselves into it. Children are continuously learning from surroundings. His letter showed me how it feels to reach your first milestone in life. But there are millions of children confused in this context of contaminating gender inequality. Hope this message finds you and gives you something valuable that inspires you to act. Thanks a lot for watching my Sri Lanka experience.